looks like it's done. Welcome, Q, to the NYU Tandon School of Engineering. The course that I'm responsible for is called Introduction to Engineering and Design. It's an experiential course where every week we're dealing with a different engineering discipline. And one of the reasons they like this course, it's not just theory, they're actually applying practical things in a hands-on environment. I have a live microphone, so I got to be careful of what I say. I want to go down to the BDR and see how that's doing. Hi, how's the robot doing? The intent for the robot in this course is to start from the beginning point, traverse through until it can push that white button in the background. Now comes the moment of truth. Wow. Now that's what I call a spectacular programming. Now the important thing to realize about all of these robots, they're not remotely controlled. They are programmed, and the program takes into account what the terrain is like and what the robot should do. Now one of the reasons why we do this is not because we love Lego robots. The main intent here is to teach about design and the team working jointly in order to solve a problem. There's a lot of activity going on in downtown Brooklyn. Lots of buildings going up. So directly above me, there's a crane, which is helping construct a building. This crane is a study in lots of mathematics and lots of physics.
Okay, so what's a boom? Some examples are construction cranes, computer or monitor arms, cantilever bridges, and rotating bridges.
So fracture stress is P over A, where PF is the applied force and A is again the cross-sectional area.
So today we're working on a boom construction competition where students get exposed to the basics of civil engineering and structural concepts. They're designing a boom that can hold the most weight and that can be assembled in the least amount of time. Right now you're pushing here, but why don't you try pushing where the weight's going to be? One thing I would start testing is adding the string in, because that's going to make a difference as to what's the limiting factor.
This course has no prerequisites, and the people who attend this class, at this point, they do not have the mathematics in the freshman year to fully understand what it is that they're doing. So right now we recognize that the solution they're trying to do is a trial and error based on intuition.
Oh, you guys definitely have the most weight.
Most engineers, and certainly I, enjoy solving problems, and especially difficult problems. The first major engineering job that I had is I worked for Grumman Aerospace for the Apollo program. One of the things that I have that reminds me every day of how effective engineers can be is I have this watch. This watch was designed for NASA to work in outer space. And when you see pictures of astronauts doing things, they will all be wearing a watch just like that. Teamwork and engineering can really achieve tremendous things.